now tonight. Can you hear me now? Yes. Hello, 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 everybody. I had it on mute. It's always an ID10T error, but that's why we're here. We're getting this thing here rolling. Hope y'all are ready to get into our conversation tonight with our rep, state rep, LORANNE AUSLEY. Can't wait to get this conversation going and rolling, man. You already know what time it is. I'm so excited about what's about to pop off. This is definitely something that is monumental. It's colossal. Never had nothing like this take place or happen before on this show. And I'll let y'all know about that later on when we start talking to LORANNE. So hello to all of my features once again. Hello, hello, hello. I hope all of you all are ready for tonight, man. You don't want to miss tonight's show, man. Like I said, whether you're tuning in to this thing live or you're tuning in by the replay, you don't want to miss tonight's show, man. We getting it in with State Rep AUSLEY in a few minutes, man. We're going to get into that conversation. This is big. For those who tuning in to the very first time, for the very first time, if this is your first time watching the show and the feature, man, welcome to the feature, man. This is where we get intimate, become exclusive with all our topics and our guests. We get it in over here, Doc. We talk about stuff that everybody don't want to ask and quite a conversation that just everybody just don't get. You get all the good stuff right here on my show, man. I just want to make sure that everybody knows that this is where you get all the real deal Holyfield, man. You get the actual factual, the truth, and nothing but the truth from the folks that make this thing here happen. So for those who tuning in for the first time, man, I appreciate y'all because I promise every last one of y'all and those who tuning in to this thing on a regular basis, y'all know y'all could have been anywhere else in the world, but you're here with me, and I appreciate that. So I'm going to get into it because if you want to be a part of my show, you got to do this. Email me at thefeature.cj3@gmail.com. If you want to make sure you hit me up directly, contact me through Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at my handle at thefeature with CJ3. I'm on every single night, Monday through Friday at 9 p.m. on YouTube and on Twitch and on Facebook. Go subscribe now. The feature with CJ3 on the YouTube and Twitch channels, man. Please go subscribe right now. And listen and download on all major outlets and podcasts or wherever you go enjoy your podcasts. And please donate and support the cause. Please send your donations to our Cash App at $RightTouchSports, PayPal, paypal.me, RightTouchCJ3. Or Anchor at anchor.fm/thefeaturedwithCJ3. And please go download and watch the replays of our past Feature Fridays. Guests, there is a nugget of knowledge in each conversation waiting for you. And if you want to be a sponsor or an advertiser, or you want to be featured on the show, please hit us up through our Cash App at $RightTouchSports. Hey. We about to get it in, man. You already know what time it is. We about to get into the conversation that everybody's kind of been away from. I've been promoting it, trying to put everybody on game. Facebook, I'm back on this thing just for y'all. I had to bring this thing back to Facebook, man. Listen, some of y'all are very obedient. Some of y'all aren't on Facebook. I done been told y'all we done left Facebook. I need y'all to go subscribe on YouTube. I be meaning that. Go subscribe on YouTube. I'm trying to monetize this thing. I need the subscribers. So please, take all my subscribers from Facebook. It's all good. Just go make a subscription on YouTube. It's free. You ain't got to pay. It's free. I just want the numbers. And I need y'all to make sure that y'all also tune in every night, Monday through Friday, live on YouTube. Because it may not be on Facebook all the time. I just brought it to Facebook tonight because I did not want y'all to miss this LORANNE AUSLEY conversation. Y'all seen what's been going on in the news. Y'all hear what's been going on, what's been talked about. This woman been drugged in the mud. And then at the same time, she's trying to keep a slave, keep a clean name out there as she's running for the Florida Senate right now. So I'm finna hit her up. We finna talk. Y'all listen. And y'all make y'all some decisions based off the conversation, especially if y'all have not voted out there. And for those who have voted already, hey, you're about to meet the person that you met, that you voted for. And for those who haven't voted, you're about to get to know the person that you might want to go vote for. So we're going to call her up. See what happens. Rep Ausley.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing great.
Awesome, 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 man. I'm so happy that you got on the call with me today and on the show. Thank you. Thank you so much for this opportunity. I thank you so much. I know there's a lot going on. You know, you're a busy woman. I know it's late, but I appreciate you doing this. I really do.
Well, I appreciate you having me.
Man, my pleasure to Rep Ausley, man. I'm just blessed and fortunate and just so honored to have you on the show. First of all, you know, with everything that's happening with your campaign and whatnot, this is, I felt, was just the best way to get another voice and to get another opportunity to get on a platform where you can get your name out there some more. At the same time, get the community and my listeners and the folks that are out there that are voters, get a little bit more familiar with you and who you are, what you stand for, and what the people can expect from you.
I appreciate it.
Man, my pleasure. So if you don't mind, you know how we are. We have a great rapport thus far. It's just a pleasure to know you, at the same time get an honor to work alongside you in our field of what we do. And I'm just elated to have you on the show. And I want to just love on you tonight, give you an opportunity to talk to the people, speak your mind, speak from your heart. I'm asking all questions. The gloves are coming off tonight, and it's on and popping, okay? Cool. Now, for those who don't know, the music that was just playing on some of the on my brief before we got into the segment with this conversation, that was her son, Will Holloman. So I got to put that nugget on there. All the music that you're going to hear tonight throughout my whole show is going to be her son, Will Holloman. So I got to drop that one for you. Will's music is hot.
Well, I'm glad you like it because, you know, it's kind of, I have to say, it's a different music than I'm used to.
Right.
So, he keeps reminding me that, what, you know, I say, you know, we used to play real music because he's a drummer.
Right.
And he said, Mom, what I do is real music.
Absolutely, absolutely. Well, you let Will know we love it, and he is jamming, and we're going to kick him all night. He representing Mom tonight. Absolutely. Now, give all the people just a little bit. Where are you from originally?
Well, right here in Tallahassee. I've lived most of my life here, and I love this community. And, you know, I've been honored and blessed and privileged to serve for now 12 years in Florida House representing mostly on county. And even the parts that I didn't represent, you know, you and on the south side, that is the part of the community that's most in my heart with the work that we do together down there.
Right, absolutely, absolutely. Now, you're from here. Now, tell me about your family makeup. Mom, dad, sisters, brothers, how was that?
So, my dad grew up here in Tallahassee as well, and mm-hmm. My mom is from a little town in the middle of Florida called Arcadia. And
okay.
She was at FSU, and they, you know, started a family and a life here. I'm the oldest of three. I have a brother who also lives here, and he's got three awesome daughters that are my nieces.
Awesome.
And one of whom will be voting for the first time, which is very exciting.
Awesome.
Actually, two, I think, will be voting for the first time. And then, my sister lives out in Wyoming. She's a smart one, I guess. Lives in Jackson Hole. So I get to go visit a beautiful part of the country when I go visit my niece and nephew and my sister. So that's part of my family. And then my husband and I have been married for 20 years. And our son, Will, who we've already talked about, is 17 years old. And many of your listeners may know his story, but we can talk about that. He's my miracle boy. He was born at 17 years ago, but he was at 22 weeks gestation, so just a little bit of halfway through my pregnancy.
Mm-hmm.
He was in the NICU he weighed just 1 pound, 3.7 ounces when he was born.
Wow.
And he lived in the NICU at Tallahassee Memorial Hospital for 4 months before we were allowed to bring him home. And when he came home, he was on oxygen for about you know, half a year and heart rate monitor and all those scary, scary things.
Right.
But he, he lost vision in one eye. Mm. And so he's visually impaired. But, you know, what God, I firmly believe that when God takes a little bit away, he gives you a lot more.
Absolutely.
That's where that musical talent comes from, I'm sure.
Absolutely. Wow. Now, just even having that little tidbit of a fact upon it and listening to his music thus far, man, that's definitely a story and a blessing and a testimony all in one, for real. Absolutely. Now, what high school did you go to here in Tallahassee?
I was a proud graduate of Leon's High School. Go Big Red.
Okay.
Will is a junior. He's doing the Digital Academy this year at Leon as well. But
okay.
It's an interesting career he's taken because he went, last year he went to the Florida School for the Deaf and Blind over in St. Augustine.
Right.
Which was a great school.
Mm-hmm.
But he really wanted to come back to Leon, and I'm proud of him for that because it's, you know, it's tough to navigate around that enormous campus with basically a pretty severe visual impairment, but he's doing Digital Academy now, but I'm proud of him, and I know once they get back to school, he's going to be excited to be back on the camp, back running the halls of Leon.
Absolutely, absolutely. Now, tell us, now after Leon and everything, you went to college. Now, what school did you go to?
I went to a small college in Virginia called Randolph-Macon, and it's a liberal arts college, and I had a great experience there. And then I took some time after college and worked for Governor Bob Graham. Some people may remember Bob.
Oh yeah, absolutely remember Bob Graham.
Yeah, he was the governor of Florida. And
yeah.
Running for the United States Senate, so I got to go my first sort of taste of politics. I worked on his campaign for the United States Senate. And worked on a statewide campaign and worked in his office in Washington for a couple of years.
Wow.
Really got to see a true public servant at work.
Wow, that's absolutely incredible. Working at under Bill Graham on his campaign. Now, Randolph-Macon College, that was a woman's college at one point, right?
It was. It is not anymore, but right. It was. Really good experience.
Mm-hmm.
Lots of time to study and not get distracted by other things.
Right.
So, it's a beautiful part of the country. And,
right.
It's a great experience to go away. A lot of times, for the first couple of years, I really was jealous of my friends down here. A lot of them that went to Florida State,
mm-hmm.
who involved Greek life and all that stuff.
Right.
I think it ended up being a good
decision for me. That's good. That's awesome. Now, and after college and everything, and after you did the Bill Graham working with his campaign, you attended law school.
Back in Virginia, I went to law school, and then I practiced law for a few years in Miami, and then kind of got the political bug and gave it a shot. And then ended up working for the Florida State Senate and for Bill Clinton's first presidential campaign.
Wow. Now, what was that experience like?
It was great. I was on the Florida finance staff, so helping to raise money and to fund the campaign. And Florida, even that was in 1992. And Florida was just like today, a battleground state in the presidential election. And we didn't quite pull Clinton over. Florida didn't, but everybody else did. And
right.
But then I had the great opportunity to go work in the Clinton administration, and I did some really cool stuff. I worked with Secretary Rob Brown, who was Secretary of Commerce.
Right.
Worked in tourism, and then really cool went over to HUD, Housing and Urban Development,
mm-hmm.
And worked with Andrew Cuomo, who's now the governor of New York.
Wow.
And we worked together on empowerment zones. A lot of kind of similar to what we're trying to do now, bringing businesses into underserved neighborhoods and empowerment zones.
Right.
But the coolest thing we did there was Andrew and I worked together on what we call the Rebuilding Task Force. That was in the mid to late 90s.
Mm-hmm.
There were a number of church burnings around the country, mostly African American churches.
Right.
Most call, and I mean, it was, you know, clearly racially motivated. And we, because HUD had a loan guarantee program, we put together a task force, and we brought together, we pulled pastors from these impacted churches, brought them all together in different cities around the country, and brought resources to them, whether it be loans, grants, volunteer, or even like lumber to rebuild. And through that, I actually met a pastor in a church right here in Tallahassee, right where in the neighborhood where we're working, Pastor Mack of Faith Christian Family Center, which is right there on the corner of Lorley and Argyle, Lorley and
Meridian,
I guess.
Right.
And their church had been closer in the South City area and had been burned, and we relocated them to that used to be a white church, and it's
right
now Faith Christian Family Center. They've been there, you know, for over 20 years. But
wow.
I didn't know them until I met them through HUD in Washington, and now they're some of my lifelong friends right here in Tallahassee, back in the neighborhood where I work, and it's really cool.
Man, that's awesome. That's awesome, man. So, just piggyback on some things right quick, talking to the state rep, LORANNE AUSLEY. What made you want to study law?
You know, my father and my grandfather were practicing law at the age of 83.
Wow.
In the law firm that his father started with former
Governor
Leroy Collins, who
wow. Right, absolutely. Now, what made you want to get into politics? Absolutely, absolutely. Now, as a House rep, you ran for Florida House Representative. What was the feeling like when you won for the first time?
Let's lay the scene here, because it was 20 years ago.
Right.
It was the year 2000.
Wow.
That was quite an interesting election.
Yes, it was. I was in college, so I was around.
Okay, so it was a wild time here. You know, every TV outlet from all around the world was here.
Yes.
We were 36 days of not knowing who our president
Right.
Florida legislature was called into session. Here we are, brand, and there's 63 new freshmen because term limits had just taken effect. So more than half of the members of the House have never set foot in the chamber. And we're potentially, you know, having an impact on the presidential election. It was really wild.
Wow. That's crazy. That is crazy, especially around that time, because I do remember when we was the holdup to find out who was going to be the president. So trust me, I definitely do remember that.
It's so awkward because it would go one way, and the court would decide this, and then another court would decide that.
Right.
So
yeah.
It was a roller coaster. Yay, we won! Oh, no, it didn't. Scenario,
yeah, it's real crazy. Now, yeah, you also ran for Florida CEO at the CFO, excuse me, but you lost to the campaign to Jeff Atwater. Now, what was that loss like, and what did that teach you?
Well, you know what? I think it was a great experience. I think that I learned a lot.
Running,
this is a huge space.
Right.
Right. Every county.
Right.
And so every corner of the state, got to know people in every corner of the state, and it was a fantastic experience. That was 2010, which was not a great year. I was running as the Democratic nominee. Alex Sink was at the top of the ticket. So, you know, at one point it was supposed to have been the year of the woman.
Right.
Real
friends are. You're right. Absolutely. You're right about that. Now, you're currently in your second term as a member of the House. What are the major responsibilities you carry out on a day-to-day basis?
So, you know, I think most people know we're a citizen legislature, which means it's not a full-time job.
Right.
And so we have committee meetings, and when we're here in committee meetings, pretty much a full-time, you know, during those weeks we're in the Capitol having meeting with constituents. And then in the off weeks, you know, it's whatever legislative work and constituent work that you have. For me, you know, I don't have to travel like everyone else does. So, I mean, it's really, I think, the best possible scenario because I, you know, it's not too far for me. It's about a mile for me to get to the Capitol.
Right.
Right. So I made it a point to have Democrats and Republicans over here Syracuse by day, but we can realize that we're all human beings, because I think that makes us all better public servants and better legislators if you don't demonize the other side.
Right. That is the truth. That is absolutely the truth. You're currently running for the Florida Senate. Now, what are your plans once elected as Senator?
Well, we gotta get elected first, and I'm not right. gonna take a this is, I'm sure everyone's seen, this has been a real tough race.
Yeah.
I'm excited about the opportunity of continuing my service. You know, I've spent most of my legislative career focused on our children, Courtney and I. Well, not Courtney now has carried on, but Hometown Leon, which is an organization that I founded, and it's focused on making sure every child has the best start in life.
Right.
That's the state. There's still not enough support or investment in the first years of life. We know so much. There's so much brain research that tells us that 90% of that development takes place in the first 5 years of life. Mm-hmm. We invest so much in other parts. Continuing in my quest for greater investment or learning, continuing to be a strong advocate for public education, strong advocate for our state employees. My house district is the district with the largest number of public employees, and I have long fought for pay raise and continue healthcare benefits and all, even during COVID, mm-hmm. did a lot of advocating for, making sure that there's information about leave and making sure our safe workplaces and such. Trying to be the strongest advocate for public employees that I can be. Really proud that we were able to secure a pay raise this session. I think I've done, I'm proud of a lot of legislation that I've passed outright. Proud of a lot of work I've done on, worked with other people to get things done or to stop bad things. Mm-hmm. I think I'm probably proudest of the work I've done in the community. Being in the legislature is not just all about passing laws and being in session. It is also about giving me a platform to be a, convener and a community leader. And so through that, being able to pull together a coalition like Whole Child Leon, or to bring purpose-built communities to the south side of Tallahassee, those are things that, that I work on in the legislative process, but it's not really the legislative work. It's community work that's enabled because of my legislative position, if that makes sense.
Right, absolutely. Absolutely, absolutely. Now, for those who may not know, as far as, for people who are voting and some people who really don't really understand the legislative talk and everything, why do we have a Senate in addition to the House?
Well, so the House is, the House is a body of 120 members.
Mm-hmm.
They're smaller, and it's a little bit of a, I would say, scrappier place, wherever, it does tend to be more partisan. The Senate is a body of 40 members.
Mm-hmm.
So the districts are much, much larger, and, the Senate, in my experience, has been a more collegial body where party lines don't matter as much, and mm-hmm. people work hard to get things done. I have been, it's real important that both houses work together, and
right.
I've been fortunate for my entire House career. My first 8 years, I served with Al Lawson as our senator, and really learned from him. Talk about an advocate for state employees. He's just been fantastic.
Oh, yeah, love Al Lawson. Shout out to Al Lawson.
Oh, yeah. And Senator Mumford has just been an amazing public servant. And so, I've just both of their support and endorsement in this race, and I will, of course, listen to them and continue to learn from them, because they both have been and continue to be such important stewards and servants for our area.
Absolutely, absolutely. Now, how are you planning to protect the minorities and the small voices of the people who are struggling day to day?
Well, I think if you look at my record, that's what I've done for my entire life. Those who don't really have a voice.
Right.
And just from our, you know, from our youngest children to citizens with disabilities to the work that I've done, again, in the South Side, and just recently, just this past session, really proud of the work we did in two areas. If you remember the racially restrictive covenants that were uncovered in the Benton Hills area, I've worked with Reverend Holmes and Jamie Coleman and others. We had this task force. We decided that we wanted to be the lead, you know, the nation in removing these covenants from our real estate documents. Mm-hmm. And so we, just in one session, we were able to, I filed a bill with Senator Mumford, and instead that bill itself didn't pass, but we got this important language tacked onto a housing discrimination bill with that Representative Davis out of Jacksonville let us use that as a vehicle. So we have, we took a real strong step in helping to address that issue, and I'm really proud of it. Another issue that we worked on this year that impacts communities of color is the heirs property bill, and it's a long-standing, you know, folks whose property is passed down without a will.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of real estate speculators were taking advantage of these families. If there's, you know, a large family, six or seven brothers and sisters that own a piece of property all together, if one of the siblings decides to sell, then the whole property has to be sold, and many times it's at a very low cost, and the family loses the property and also has a, you know, at a very, without making much money on it. We now are in line with some other states to set up a process that protects those landowners. And it's many, and there's a lot of research. There's just many African-American families that have been impacted by this, and this is one step to sort of remedy that. It's complicated, and I didn't do a very good job of explaining it, but I'm proud of my work on that as well.
Absolutely, absolutely. Now, what do you feel is the most pressing political issue of the day is right now?
I think that our country is experiencing a reckoning that is long overdue, racial injustice. And I think, you know, I don't know why all of a sudden everyone's paying attention.
Right.
But it's tough. But we have to take advantage of this moment.
Yeah.
I think it's a combination of people being stuck in their home and seeing the 9 minutes George Floyd, and all of a sudden awakening.
Mm-hmm.
But we have to move forward, and we have to move forward now. So much of our work that we're doing together in South City is based in equity and looking at everything through an equity lens.
Right.
And really trying to, you know, both of the things I talked about, the racially restrictive covenants and the heirs property, are really vestiges of long-standing structural racism that have been, you know, that have been policies and practices over centuries that have created these inequities in wealth and inequities in homeownership and inequities in education and, you know, environmental injustices and all the things that we're now talking about. It is time for our country to move forward. And frankly, the only way we can do that is if we have a new president. And that, you know, so much of this is the flames of this are fanned by the president, President Trump.
Mm-hmm.
I think this is the most important election. I mean, my election's important, but it pales in comparison to the importance of electing Joe Biden.
Absolutely. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. You are absolutely correct about that. Now, just a quick little input. This is actually a two-part question for you. How are senators assigned to committees, and what is the Florida Senate completely?
What is, I don't understand the second question.
Well, as far as what part of government does the Florida Senate serve?
My best for a reference is the House right now, but
right.
That, as I, you know, they're similar. So So the House and the Senate are, you know, the work that we do, when I talk to school kids, I often say it's almost like being back in school. Mm-hmm. Because we get assigned to these committees, which are really sort of like your classes.
Right.
Go to the meetings, and you have to study up on the issues, and you have to, you know, you have to vote. You have to make a decision.
Mm-hmm.
On, you know, but you can't do that without being informed, and you have to listen to both sides. So those committees are really important.
Mm-hmm.
And what I didn't understand until I got elected the first time is that it's all of those decisions are up to the Speaker of the House and the President of the Senate.
Right.
Those two people, the presiding officers of both chambers, are very, very powerful. They not only decide what committees we serve on and who are the chair, you know, who is the leadership of those committees, but they decide what about, you know, each member of the legislature in the House, we have six bills that we can file, and the Senate, the senator has an unlimited number of bills to file. But those bills, you know, it's the Speaker and the Senate President that decide what those bills go to.
Mm.
So such that they decide the fate of your legislation before, because just by the committee, if it gets six committee references, then it has to go in and out of. You know that means the Speaker didn't like your bill and it's not going anywhere. So,
right.
A lot of decision making and power in those in the Senate President and the Speaker of the House.
Right. Absolutely. Wow. That's well explained. I'm just hoping everybody that's listening, all my listeners out there, y'all are getting educated on what's the difference between the House and the Senate at the same time. What to look forward to as far as when it's time to go to these polls and make your decision well known. Now, what's the feeling like, because you spoke of it earlier as far as being endorsed by Al Lawson and being endorsed by several others, but you got a huge endorsement by the 44th president, Barack Obama, by far the best president ever. What was that feeling like, being endorsed by Barack Obama?
Well, I have to say, a real privilege of a lifetime, and I am very proud that I was one of the first elected officials in Florida to endorse then Senator Obama.
Mm-hmm.
March of 2007. So he coming through Tallahassee, and I met him. And it's funny, my mom, who is like a Southern lady from DeSoto County, Florida,
uh-huh.
My mom has been. She had been giving him money, like she had been following him and sending little contributions to him. And I'm thinking to myself, if my mom is, you know, is intrigued enough to follow this, you know, Senator Obama right now. And I had heard him speak at the national convention.
Mm-hmm.
It was so inspiring. My mom being a supporter made me realize that there was a path for him, you know,
mm-hmm.
and do everything I could to make that path possible. So getting him jumping out there early was exciting. I got to meet him a couple times when he came through Florida. I got to introduce both him one time and Michelle another time. And I remember sitting in a room just the two of us. He didn't even have Secret Service at the time.
Wow.
And I had just CFO race, and we had this just most honest conversation. I asked him, how are you doing? And he said, I miss my daughters. And he told me he had been reading every Harry Potter book with them from the road.
Wow.
Just read the last, but it was really cool. It was a really cool experience. So anyway, to for him to sort of repay the favor in a real meaningful way, in a
right.
way that I really a lot more than this little tiny House member endorsing him back then, but it means a lot.
Wow, that is absolutely cool, man. That's a heck of a story too, man. That's pretty awesome. Now, how should I put this? Now, getting into it, because I've been kind of waiting for it. Now, just to kind of go ahead and put this out there, everybody that's in your skin, or look like it's all the skin folk or the color skin folks, we all ain't kinfolk. Okay, I'm just gonna put that out there. Now, your opponent is not a nice one, and to a lot of my people, she's looked upon as a traitor, a black face, and a Trump do girl. Marva Preston, it's sad to say the least, being an African American person myself, witnessing such foolishness. But not everyone is, you know, is educated or as educated as they proclaim. She's talking some hard stuff and taking some big jabs at you, and has really, really just, you know, just came out of nowhere. And, you know, one thing she doesn't have is any political experience. She's lied about her upbringing and just a bad look for my culture altogether. But to you as your opponent, and all the things that's being said about you, and all the negative things and stuff that they're putting out there, how do you wish to respond to all the negativity that's put out there about you right now?
Well, you know, I think the most important thing for people to take away from this is that, you know, we have a clear choice, and that, you know, someone with a record of service, and I'll stand by that record all day long, or someone who's taken pages from the Trump playbook and trying to tear me down at every moment with flat-out lies and distortions of the truth. Everything from suggesting that I took PPP money, which is a flat-out lie, she knows it, to the fact that I turned my back on Hurricane Michael victims, when, in fact, my no vote on that budget was because it did not have enough money for Hurricane Michael victims.
Wow.
And, you know, so, and I said it very clearly, and it's very on the record, and, you know, so to take those types of things, and that hurts, you know, when I've spent hours and days, and, you know, I went out to Spain Hill 2 days after the hurricane, and I didn't stop. Still haven't stopped. I'm still going out there and helping and working for my legislative office. So but it also has brought forth a lot of folks who know me and know my heart and know my service.
Mm-hmm.
You know, standing up for me, and I will just say, you know, I have a proven track record of solving problems, and I think right now, the next Senate and legislature is going to face a $2.4 billion budget shortfall. Mm-hmm. We need to be focused on that. We need to be focused on things that build bridges and bring people together.
Right.
And instead of taking, you know, the Donald Trump playbook and tearing everybody apart, I think our citizens, you know, we're just tired of that. And there's so many people that are hurting and suffering right now.
Mm-hmm.
We need to be focused on how to address that. And this kind of bickering back and forth doesn't help anybody.
Absolutely. You ain't lying about that. Now, they say you stole money and all this good stuff, and that wasn't yours. What money are they particularly talking about?
So, the Florida Democratic Party did apply for a PPP loan, which many small businesses did. And there's clear prohibition against political parties taking that money.
Right.
So, all of us, once we learned of this, stepped up and condemned it, and they ultimately turned that money back. But none of that money ever made it to any of our campaigns. It's not the way, it doesn't happen that way. So, you know, and every dollar of that I have spent on that I've raised is from over 1,000 individual contributors. And every one of those is reported on a, you know, monthly and now weekly, bi-weekly basis. So you can look at the Florida Division of Elections and see, you know, who has contributed to my campaign and what expenditures my campaign has made. So it's very clearly public record, and none of that money that the Florida Democratic Party took, they gave back, and none of that made it to any of our campaigns. It's using it across the state in a number of races, and it's confusing, and it's confusing voters, but it's been found to be untrue in every market that they've tried it.
Wow, man.
But they keep using it. You know?
Yeah, right.
It's like no regard for the truth. And I think, you know, again, I think and the voters can see through that, I hope. And all we can do is continue to expose the lies and point towards the truth in my years of records of service.
Absolutely. Now, what's one thing you know that you got one up on Marvin Preston?
Well, I 12 years of service, and they point to that as if it's a liability.
Right.
I think right now, what you don't want a surgeon that didn't go to medical school. And right now, you need officials that are making decisions in these very challenging times who understand the process and who know how to work with both sides of the aisle to get things done. And that's, you can't walk into this job and learn on the fly. I mean, it's a $90 billion budget is a huge budget, and there are a lot of decisions that have to be made. And I think, I am proud of my public service.
Right.
Shy away from telling people about it, because I think that is a very important strength that I bring.
Absolutely. Absolutely, man. Talking to Rep. LORANNE AUSLEY, Florida Rep, House Representative, and 2020 Florida Senate candidate. Rep. AUSLEY, what's one thing you want to say to my listeners out there and those who are voters out there who have voted or hadn't voted yet? What's one of the things you want to say to the people as far as how can they feel safe and secure in the decision they make in voting for you?
I think they can look at my record of service. I think they can look at those who have stood up for me, from Barack Obama to Al Lawson, people who are very household names around here.
Mm-hmm.
Voters in Leon County, I hope are familiar with my work, not just in the legislature, but my work in the community. And I think, the most important thing is people know my heart.
Right.
I believe in public service. I believe that it is, to whom much is given, much is required.
Expected. Right.
I'm very fortunate, to have a healthy family and a husband and a law career. And I just believe that it is it's important to give back and to wake up every day and try to make a difference in someone else's life. And I've done that, and maybe I haven't done a great job telling that story because I don't do it because of the story. I do it because it's in my heart. And I hope that people know that and can hear that sincerity. We've got a lot of work to do between now and Tuesday. So anybody that's out there that wants to come out and help us, we've got lots of community activities going on this weekend, and would love to have your support and have it's
going to
be a fun 5 days as we head toward the finish line here.
Absolutely. Rep, I'll tell the people, all my listeners, how they can follow you, how they can reach out to you, how they can contribute to your campaign and all that good stuff.
So the easiest way is to go to our website, which is AUSLEYforSenate.com. I'm also going to give you my campaign manager. He told me to give you the phone number because his name is Jerome Maple, and
that's right.
Safely with masks. And I want to be real. I hope everybody is as serious as I am. This is hard during COVID to be running for office.
But right.
This is not over, and we got to be real careful. So, but we're going to do it safely in our green shirts. And so, again, 850-210-4198 is Jerome, and AUSLEYforSenate.com. You can sign up to volunteer there. You can sign up to wave sign.
Awesome. Senator Rep. AUSLEY, I thank you so much for coming on to the show. I appreciate your time and all that good stuff. But before I let you go, I got to get into my favorite part of my segment when I'm interviewing my people. It's a podcast. I say, would you rather? And this is a segment of questions that I ask when you tell me, would you rather this or would you rather that? Okay, you ready?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, would you rather, and being that you're about to be in the process of becoming one of these, and you was in the process of becoming another one, would you rather be a senator or be the Florida CFO?
I think I'd rather be a senator.
Mm. Okay. Can you elaborate, or you, that's pretty much it?
I like the legislative process.
Okay.
I like the, you know, the back and forth and the little bit of debate on things. And I mean, I think I excel in the, yeah, I don't know. I like that legislative.
Okay, awesome. Would you rather, and knowing you, I know you're very active, very fit, would you rather go for a run or go biking?
I think it depends on where I am, but I think I'd rather go for a run, really.
Okay.
I started, I did triathlon, and I started as a runner.
I know.
And that's the thing. I can't do it every day and stay healthy. I mean, so that's the biking to me allows me to be, and the swimming allows me to keep healthy without injuries. If I could run every day, I would.
Absolutely. That sounds about right. Now, would you rather be underestimated as a senator or overestimated as a senator?
I'd rather underpromise and
overdeliver. I see. Okay. I like what you did there. Okay. Would you rather see Biden win and serve under Biden, or see Trump win and serve 4 more years?
Is that a trick question? the soul of our nation is at stake here, and I would absolutely rather see, and I hope that we wake up with a clear, decisive victory for Joe Biden on Wednesday morning.
Absolutely.
Thank you, our nation.
Absolutely. Would you rather be more inclusive with connecting with the people or be more inclusive with foreign policies?
Well, connecting with the people. In the job in the Senate, that's what I do.
Right. Absolutely. And would you rather beat Marvin Preston in a 12-round boxing match or beat Marvin Preston in a triathlon?
Definitely a triathlon.
Okay. And last but not least, would you rather hear from Marvin Preston to congratulate you on your win, or would you rather do a handstand on your win? Okay, we take a boat. Rep. LORANNE AUSLEY, I thank you. I graciously appreciate your time. Thank you for coming on the feature. You're off the hot seat. Thank you so much. Good luck with everything with the campaign. You know you already got my vote. And everybody, please, please encourage everybody to go vote before you leave. Please.
Yep. Vote like your life depends on it. Thank you.
My pleasure. Thank you, Rep. I'll talk to you later.
Okay.
Love you, girl. Take care. Bye now. Man, just had a conversation with the Rep. AUSLEY, man. I hope you guys have taken this into deep consideration as far as what she's doing, what she got going on. Definitely a woman of public service, been doing it for 20 years plus, has definitely stood the test of time as far as trying to make things happen for the Southside community of Tallahassee and just for the community of Tallahassee, period, across the country, across the state. And, man, hopefully we get some good results for her on Tuesday, man, on Wednesday as well, finding out the results of everything from the actual campaign, man. This has been amazing. This has been fun. Have had Rep. LORANNE AUSLEY on the show, man. This has been amazing. Just can't do nothing but get better, man. You already see what we're doing. We got things popping off right now, man. So, you know what time it is. Finna make this thing happen, man. If you want to be on the show, hit me up. Download. Hit me up. Email me at thefeature.cj3@gmail.com. Or if you want to hit me up through Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, hit me up, man, at The Feature with CJ3. I'm on every single night, Monday through Friday at 9 p.m. on Facebook, YouTube, and on Twitch. Please go subscribe right now to the YouTube channels, The Feature with CJ3. And listen and download on all major outlets and podcasts or wherever you go enjoy your podcasts. And please donate and support. Please send your donations to my Cash App at $ Right Touch Sports, PayPal.me/RightTouchCJ3, or on Anchor at anchor.fm/TheFeatureWithCJ3. Please go download and watch the replays of past Feature Friday's guests. There is a negative knowledge in each conversation. Waiting for you. And if you want to be on the feature, you want to sponsor the feature, you want to send your Cash App to the featured man, send your money to our Cash App at $ Right Touch Sports. Yeah, man. So you already know what's going on. Man, we just got finished talking with Rep. AUSLEY, man. It's Fan Floss, 2020 Florida Senate candidate right now, man. It's going down. Listen. We getting it all right here, dog. We do not play. We let everything out here on this show. Ain't nobody got, hey, look, all the gloves come off, and we don't hold nothing back. It's about that time for you boys' song of the night. Yes, and we about to get into it right now. My song of the night comes from some real political brothers in the hip-hop game, shall I say. They actually have already kind of done their political services on a lot of these brothers are straight militant, perfect for tonight's conversation. And at the same time, you know, one of them from Tallahassee, Florida, so represent that. And that another one is from New York. And y'all know them, y'all done played their music on here before, but tonight's song is just tailor made, man. It's just perfect. And I'm finna get right into it right now. It's my boys. Y'all got to get ready for this because this one hits serious, man. Hey, if your mindset ain't on this stuff, because it's real out here. I don't know if y'all realize it, but the stuff that's going on out here in this world, man, it's bigger than us. It's bigger than all the stuff that's going on. If y'all don't pay attention to what's happening in this world, it's bigger than what's going on, man. It's bigger than hip-hop. I can guarantee you that much. So I need y'all to go ahead and get y'all minds right. Get that thing cracking with my boys' Dead Prayers.
One thing about music, when it hit, you feel no pain. White folks that controls your brain, I know better than that. That's game, man, we ready for that. Two soldiers head of the pack, matter of fact, who got the gat? And where my army at? Rather attack and not react. Back to beats, it don't reflect on how many records get sold on sex, drugs, and rock and roll. Whether your projects put on hold in the real world. These just people with ideas, they just like me and you. When the smoke and cameras disappear again, the real world. It's bigger than all these fake-ass records. Wait, folks got the millions and my woman. Disrespected. If you check 1, 2, my word of advice to you is just relax. Just do what you got to do. If that don't work, then kick the facts. If you a fighter, rider, bada, flame ignite, crowd excited. Oh, you wanna just get hot and just say it. But then if you a lie, pants on fire, wolf cry, agent with a why, I'm gonna know it when I play it. It's bigger than hip hop, hip hop, hip hop, hip. It's bigger than hip hop. Hip hop, hip hop, hip hop. Who shot Biggie Smalls in If we don't get them, they gon' get us all. I'm down for running up on them crackers in they city hall. We ride for y'all, all my dogs, stay real. Nigga, don't think these record deals gon' feed your season, pay your bills, because they not. MCs get a little bit of love and think they hot. Talking about how much money they got. Nigga, all y'all records sound the same. I'm sick of that fake thug R&B rap scenario. All day on the radio, same scenes in the video. Monotonous material, y'all don't hear me though. These record labels slang, I chase like dope. You could be next in line and sign and still be writing rhymes and broke. You would rather have a Lexus or justice, a dream or some substance, a beamer, a necklace, or freedom. Still a nigga like me don't play a hate, I just stay awake. This real hip hop, and it don't stop till we get the popo off the block. They call it hip hop, hip hop, hip hop, hip. It's bigger than hip hop, hip hop. DP's got that crazy shit. She keep it clocked up, John Blaze and shit. What? DP's got that crazy shit. She keep it clocked up, John Blaze and shit.
What a nigga wanna do?
DP's got that crazy shit. She keep it clocked up, John Blaze and shit.
What you, what you?
DP's got that crazy shit. She keep it clocked up, John Blaze and shit. DP's got that crazy shit. She keep it clocked up.
Tune in this weekend, this Friday, October 30th, talking to the Coach Courts and Comptroller of Leon County, the first female, first black elect, and the first black female elect, the one and only Gwen Marshall, right here on The Feature, man. Please tune in right here on The Feature. Don't be late. Please make sure y'all tune in, man. This Friday, because it's definitely going down, I need you here. 9 o'clock. Tune in. Listen to this awesome woman, man, and her great story and the plan that she got and what's going on. But I'd be so remiss if I didn't tell y'all this. November 6th, the personal trainer to the celebrities, businessman and professional model, my brother Jarrell Webb, on right here, The Feature, November 6th, talking to none other than the chief of police of Tallahassee, the police department, on November 13th, my Rick's brother, Chief Lawrence Rebel, and on November 20th, the highly sophisticated and highly brilliant and intelligent community activist, South City Foundation's go-to girl, Tallahassee Peacemaker, and first king of royalty, Christine Henry. And please save the date for the season finale of The Feature, of our Feature Fridays. My brother, my homie, my one of my good dear friends, college football icon, national champion, Florida football, Florida State football, Seminole legend, Mr. Peter Ward, right here on the show, man. Please be sure to tune in. Hey, hey. Try to tell you, man, that's what we do, man. We gotta make this thing happen, man. Oh, man, this has been an awesome night already, Doc. I'm trying to tell you now. It's already been a good night. Now it's time for one of them boys, CJ3's True Stories. And this is a part of the show where I try to tie a true story to either the topic or our special guest. And we had an awesome and special guest tonight. State Rep, LORANNE Ausley. One of the beautiful things about LORANNE Ausley that I've gotten a chance to witness first and foremost, up close and personal, working under her and working with her, actually, with the South City Foundation. She's the CEO of the South City Foundation, and it's been an honor and a pleasure to be in this woman's presence and meetings with her knowledge and with her ability to connect with so many different forms and walks of life at the same time, for her to be able to be such a pillar in that community, at the same time to be such a hands-on individual. Now, one of the funniest things I've ever got a chance to witness was this woman's love for South City. When she says she loved the South Side of Tallahassee, she's not lying. I swear to God, she does. So, shout out to my girl Christy, who I work very closely with the South City Foundation. Like, this is a big project. I know y'all probably be like, why you talking about South City and South City Foundation so much? I'm on a big-ass assignment right now. A lot of y'all may not understand what's going on, especially when you're talking with the rep for the state of Florida, and she's your CEO of this particular organization. Like, this is a big deal. And yes, my name, my face, and my voice, and I'm a part of this ordeal as well. I sit on the board with her, as well as on the staff. And what's the greatest and funniest thing, so me and Christine, we used to head up this operation mission that we had during the summer called the Summer Break Spot, and it was the number one summer break spot. And Rep. Osley used to just come out, show her face, show some love, and she would get so amped that she would literally do a handstand, and we would go live with this. She would do a handstand to see how long she could do a handstand on her hands for South City. And people used to try to challenge her on her handstand and could never beat this woman's time. Like, she was serious about it. She couldn't even beat her own time sometimes. It was stuff like that. And just to have that kind of spirit, kind of have that type of individual who, you know, definitely doesn't look like everybody that's on the South Side of town. Everybody on the South Side of town looked like me. And what's funny also, too, being that she came on my show and I worked alongside, close to her, I mean, this is a featured first. This is the feature with CJ3. This is a first for our show. This is the very first white person we've ever interviewed on the show. These are my truths. I can't make this stuff up. So it's really going down. It's really happening right here. And it really is what it is. I love it. I can't make this stuff up. That's my story. And I'm sticking to it. It is what it is. I love you guys. But, hey, truth is, it really, truly is what it is. Because I can't make this stuff up. But if you want to be on my show, man, hit me up. Contact me. Email me at thefeature.cj3@gmail.com. Or hit me up on my Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter accounts. At The Feature with CJ3. I'm on this thing every single day, man. Monday through Friday at 9 p.m. on Facebook, YouTube, and on Twitch. Y'all better go subscribe right damn now to The Feature with CJ3 on YouTube and on my Twitch channel. And go listen and download on all major outlets and podcasts, or wherever y'all go enjoy y'all podcasts. And please go donate and support. Go donate and support your money in Cash App at $ Right Touch Sports, PayPal at paypal.me/RightTouchCJ3, or on Anchor at anchor.fm/TheFeature with CJ3. Man, go download and watch the replays and past Feature Fridays guests that's been on Feature Fridays on The Feature. Go check them out on YouTube, on my Facebook page, and on Twitch, man. It is a nugget of knowledge waiting for you in each conversation. And don't hesitate if you want to be a feature, if you want to be an advertiser, if you want ads on the show, if you want to talk about stuff that you do, if you want to be a sponsor, you got a business and you want to get some promotion on my show, hit me up. Send your money to our Cash App. Right Touch Sports. Hey, man, listen. It's time to vote. It's time to get our minds right. It's time to get serious about our lives, man. I don't know if y'all been watching this. And I hope you have. I hope you all have really, really taken heed of what this woman has said tonight. I want to thank Rep. LORANNE AUSLEY for coming on here and expressing her true feelings and expressing her heart and giving us what she plans on doing for us when she gets in that Senate. I appreciate her opening up about how she felt about what Marvin Franklin is putting out about her and her campaign. It's a sad situation with that, and we can't change ties or change names with that. I actually know her people. Surprisingly enough, I know her people. And I hope her people, as they are looking at this show and as they see their cousin or whatever, whoever she is to y'all, out here looking foolish, out here for our culture. I want y'all to check yourselves with that too. Because at the end of the day, it's hard to trust anybody right now with how touchy racism is and social injustice. But we gotta believe in somebody. And we gotta believe in somebody who's willing to be on our side. And that's what's more important. The only way we can bring our differences to a real good meeting is if we come together, sit down at the table and have a conversation that is uncomfortable, that doesn't necessarily want to be heard or talked about all the time. I'm glad that LORANNE AUSLEY was able to come on here tonight and share those things, because at the end of the day, this is our life that we're worried about. It's our life that we need to be thinking about. Our future is at our stakes right now. Everything is. Everything is at stake. This is the biggest election of all of our lives. What are you going to do? Who are you going to vote for? How do you really want to see your life handled right now with this situation? Is it really serious about a tax break? Or do we just need a break, period? At the end of the day, it's your decision. I can't influence it. All I can hope is that the people that make these decisions for our policies and laws, that y'all are listening to them, that y'all are taking heed of what they're saying. So remember, go out and vote too. It's a very important day, November 3rd, man. It's right around the corner. Please do not forget. It is real. It is about to happen. And man, listen, regardless, words, sticks and stones may break our bones, but words would never hurt us. So shout out to LORANNE AUSLEY for coming through for us tonight. Listen to her awesome, awesome story and just her awesome plan and what she plans on doing for us, man. I appreciate all y'all for tuning in tonight, checking out the show and checking out everything, man. Yes, this is the end of my show. I hope you all have enjoyed it tonight. Lord knows I surely have. I'm going to leave y'all with my four main principles, and y'all know what they are. Number one, stay smart. It don't take a rocket science to see that this is the decisions that need to be made. Number two, stay safe. There's a lot of craziness going on out there. We need to be able to protect ourselves from it. Thirdly, stay clean. Wash your hands. Stay away from all crazy stuff, all germs, all COVID-related type practices. Yeah, just stay away from all that stuff, man. We don't need it. It's definitely something we don't need. And at the end of the day, stay your ass home.
Are you ready, people?
We don't want that shit.
Yeah. I couldn't wait till the whole world recognized. But first I had to pay some dues. The journey I took, y'all couldn't walk in my shoes. A young buck, wild and tough from Tallahassee, straight from South City in my pursuit to be happy. Came up out the hood with my hair all nappy, cut it all off, no some name, nothing. My pappy, the streets tried to trap me, but I had to escape from my destiny and wait for me to be great. And I knew it, so it was clear, had to show it proven. When I knew it, so it was stupid. Now you loving me like you pay, and I know that you wasn't ready for this. I'm from a point with my targets, I'm sure I will miss. This is the past, present, and the future. C-squared, the household name, something to get used to. I'm here. Yeah.